Hello, I'm Donna.
I'm Sarah.
And I'm Mr. Dang.
Stay tuned to hear about how this fourth grade teacher turned power addicts expert can help the next generation of students rolling into their first job looking like a rock star. Hello, welcome back to Less Code, More Power. I'm Donna.
I'm Sarah.
Today we've got a very special guest who probably all of you already know.
He doesn't need any introduction. This is like Brian Zhang. I don't think any words would ever be able to describe him in like a short sentence in any, like it won't do him fashion.
No,
like.
Not at all. But you have to introduce yourself
yeah,
anyway.
Go for it, please.
Sure.
Yeah.
But I think you guys normally call me Mr. Dang.
Yes, we do call
true.
Him Mr.
To be fair, yeah, we do.
Yeah, we do that.
And that name comes from being an elementary school teacher. Mm-hmm. I was creating apps for my classroom mm-hmm. to solve every little problem in the class.
Fourth grade classrooms, to be clear.
That's like ages 9 and 10. Mm-hmm. And we teach everything, math, science, social studies. Mm-hmm. I teach PE. That's
oh
right. Getting the kids out there.
Wow. And so, school teacher to what's your official job title now? What do you do now?
Today, I'm a power platform program manager.
Wow. Power platform program manager. Because he made a bunch of power apps for his kids. Then you had an interview with James Phillips.
James Phillips?
Yes.
And that's not all.
And?
In that interview with James Phillips, I'm showing my apps, ways that I'm bringing in educational research, methods.
Yes.
He asks me midway, Brian, would you like me to, I'm going to be meeting Bill Gates in 2 weeks. Do you want to come meet him and show your apps to him?
Wow.
And in that moment, I'm thinking, should I be snarky here and say, let me try to fit him in my calendar?
Wow.
No, I'm just kidding.
Wow.
No, I said, yes, of course,
you
yes.
You took that.
But that wasn't the end of the meeting.
No.
So I'm showing the ways that I'm pushing the limits of what Power Apps could do. Mm-hmm. It's a business applications development platform. And I was creating video games on it for my educational apps.
Amazing.
So that's when he asked me, do you want to come work at Microsoft?
And whoa.
Was you expecting it? Like in all honesty, like when you got to that question, like was it just a complete surprise? Like what was going on for you at that time?
I had left the classroom when I had discovered that I know how to make apps now. And I was able to make apps because I've got these Excel skills,
that's right?
These spreadsheet skills.
Yes.
And if I had just the right tool, I could lift that ceiling of what I could do in spreadsheets and finally solve problems in the way that I want to. And that's where Power Apps comes in. It's like that replacement for those macros that you have in Excel. Mm-hmm. It gets to that less code, more power message, where somebody who doesn't have the time to spend 4 years in a college degree can ramp up because the barrier for entry is lower, right?
That's right. Exactly.
That's amazing.
Because you don't have to go to 4 years computer science school or go to coding boot camp. You can actually just use the tools you've got available and learn things and solve your own problems.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Which is amazing.
It's accessible for all.
Exactly. So tell us, you believe in this vision of Less Code, More Power. It's affected your life dramatically. Now you have this whole another job, being a program manager at Microsoft, no longer teaching kids. But instead, you go around the world and teach people to build power apps. Mm-hmm. What is that like? Is it the same as teaching kids? Is it different than teaching kids? Because
you wasn't even subtle when you asked that question.
Exactly.
The audiences are very, very similar in some kinds of ways. I mean, you're learning something that you've never seen before. So for fourth graders, let's say we're learning something like fractions. Well, we need to make sure that we've got the right tools for learning.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So when I'm going around the world teaching something like Power Apps, we've got the right tool.
Right.
And we take it to this level where we finally solve something like a device order management.
Right.
Device order management is the tutorial that we've got for workshops around the world.
Wow.
It's a really wonderful experience to see people's eyes light up when they insert a button on the screen.
Yes.
That just does navigation to another screen.
Yes.
And see that come out.
The hello world moment.
There's so much instant gratification in building these apps.
They're like, I did this, I did that. That button was not there. It didn't used to do anything, and now it does because of me.
And then at the end of the workshop, they're They've got that app pulled up on their screen.
Yes.
Yeah, straight from here to here.
Straight from there to there.
Yes.
Regardless of their operating system, yeah. Right? That's mind-blowing.
And they're addicted.
Yeah.
And that's how power addicts happen. This is exactly how it happens.
I have a really burning question. So you've done all of this stuff. Like, it's been amazing. What's next for you? What's the thing that you're working on? What's the thing that's kind of front of mind, like your mission right now and for the rest of the year? Mm.
Mm-hmm. So there are so many audiences of people who are just like me, mm-hmm. where we don't have that feeling that we can solve problems by creating apps. My goal is to give that cognitive dissonance, put people in a position where they would have felt like all of these excuses would have been true. Like, I don't have the time to make things. Love that. I'm not a maker.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Put them in that position mm-hmm. and then show them.
Yes.
You can create this screen mm-hmm. with image controls, labels, mm-hmm. right? That's one of the first things that we do in our books workshop mm-hmm. Is to get that feeling that mm-hmm. you can. So I want to enable the next 10 million developers, mm-hmm. right, who are just like me.
Yes.
Mm. That's amazing.
These are people who say, oh, I'm not a maker, and suddenly they've made something and gone home with it. You say, in fact, you're a maker.
Yeah, it's like, and FYI, yeah. you are. That's
JFYI, the thing. You just did. Yeah.
That's the thing. It kind of blasts. And this show is very much about that, right? Especially when we get onto the homework kind of stage and stuff. But this show is all about the fact that the excuses are not real.
No.
Like, you know, we don't want those excuses. No. You can go and make a difference, like, now.
That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right. Brian and I did a workshop at the London Microsoft Store. And it was a room full of, 100 people. I would say 80 of them were like adults. And 20 of them were kids. And it was wild to see these kids and these adults, all of them making this books app. And all of them had that hello world moment where they said, oh, I can do this. I did this. And then they're all staring at the screen and they won't stop playing with their app once they make it, right? And half the room is obsessive over their pixels. They were like, no, this is the wrong icon. I don't like this icon. They were, you know, just obsessed with getting their app to look exactly right.
And like, we didn't even put in instructions for like, change the color of this,
the boldness of this. Wow, so people just did it themselves.
They just did.
They're like making it their own.
Yeah, they were like, I hate these colors, they're horrible. So this kid is like, they're orange and all. It was really interesting.
That's amazing though, like the insight, because like you're essentially just giving people a toolbox and then everyone's got their own vision, their own kind of like creativity. They can go ahead and do the things themselves that we would never have thought of.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
That's cool. Wild.
So we always have our guests bring something to show. Mm-hmm. What have you got?
All right, here's an app that has really helped me connect with our community. Mm-hmm. Some of my favorite makers are these creatives over in Japan. I speak Vietnamese, I speak English, and I'm a huge otaku, right? I love Japanese culture.
Okay.
But I don't know how to speak Japanese.
Well, why not?
I'm learning.
Okay, guess
what?
What kind of excuse is this?
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm a huge fan of the culture. Don't speak the language.
Well, you can probably guess that I'm making an app for getting to know the language a little bit more. And this is where this app comes in.
All right. Please show us.
Yeah. Today, I can already translate the tweets that our friends tweet out.
Okay.
But this one is, how do I communicate back in a faster way? And how do I communicate correctly, more accurately?
Okay.
So suppose I wanted to say something like hello. Now, I do know the word for hello in Japan.
And now this is a power app that you built.
I type in the text.
Yes.
It translates it, but it does one more thing.
Oh.
In this third field, it takes that translation to Japanese, and it brings it back into English.
To see if you've been translated right.
Yeah.
So like translate in the translation.
I'm translating the translation. Yes. Mm-hmm. This is my retranslator app. Mm-hmm.
I love that.
Yeah.
This way, you're wondering, did I say something horribly offensive? Mm. Oh no, I just said that.
Exactly.
Yes.
Which could happen, right?
That all happens all to time. Me all the time. All the time.
Mm-hmm. It's not finished though, because so I put in some audio. So you can replay this back.
Oh, wow.
But say you picked out a word that you just learned. How do you know, how have you actually acquired it? Well, I save that word. And it adds it to my existing list of words that I know.
Oh.
Oh, so you track your progress.
Show my progress.
Uh-huh.
I can search the words that I've already had.
Yes. That's cool.
But one more layer that I've added to this is I can add tags to this. I can relate each of the words. Where did I acquire a word like magic? I got it from anime. I got it from this one. Right? I'm relating all these things together.
And does that help from like a learning experience perspective?
Yes, because all learning is connected. You know how you memorize a random fact because it's related to this one time you did this one thing?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
It's all relational.
Yes.
Just like the data that we work in with business applications.
Mm. He's a teacher, he knows things.
Yeah, he does, he knows things.
I didn't know that, yeah.
That should be your new description on Twitter or something.
I'm a teacher, I know things. Yeah, that's exactly what it should be. But that is super, super cool. So what is the data source you're using to do the actual translation?
This one's using Azure's the Microsoft Translator from Azure.
Okay.
So I just plug in a key, make that connector, and it could translate to all of that, and even gives me back those sound files.
That's right. Mm-hmm. So you just use the translator connector, built a power app, use translator connector, and now he's built this very custom language learning app that works incredibly well for him to be able to prep for an upcoming trip to Japan. So you can suddenly be speaking Japanese in a context that makes sense for you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's amazing. And in real time, I guess, as well, being able to actually just go ahead and key in on your phone just a word that you really want to go ahead and, and know and go ahead and learn it. That's amazing. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I love that.
There was this one word in particular I learned on my last trip, Kaizen. It's a spirit of endless innovation. Right?
That's cool.
A spirit of endless innovation. That's
continuous,
a great word.
Continuous progress.
Mm-hmm. We should just use that word across the globe. That's a great word. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, separate topic for Brian.
Sure.
We have recently been working with this huge community of very passionate young people called the MSPs, the Microsoft Student Partners. Now, you've taken a great, great fondness for this group of people. And this group of people just adopted Brian. We've got MSPs all over the world in many, many countries. And recently you've been engaging with them. And do you want to share that experience of what that's been like, especially related to MSPs plus power apps?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was speaking with some of the MSPs just last weekend. Mm-hmm. And they had asked me to share about my personal journey. Mm-hmm. And I was sharing more about how I was a student and some nuggets of wisdom. Mm-hmm. And after that, they started coming up with some workshops to do in their own in their own environments, right? Their own regions.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
So they've really taken to it. Mm-hmm. Now, some of them come from coding backgrounds. Some of them do not.
Right.
But they're bringing on their friends who don't have that background.
That's right.
Because they can.
Yeah.
So I love that enthusiasm, I love the energy, and I encourage all of our MSPs and anybody who is in the collegiate world, if you're running like a college club, you need some business applications to run it.
Oh, yes, you have like
so many good scenarios there.
Yeah. That's so cool. Like I bet that, I bet it's quite nice to know that your story has impacted them in that way. Because the thing is, like, kind of people need like that kind of role model, that kind of, you know, that kind of story in terms of I did it, I made this possible. Because we don't know what's possible until someone's proven that kind of theory wrong in our head. Mm-hmm. So that must kind of be good. Like, does it kind of bring you happiness? And
it does. And it drives me towards this goal that I have, where I want people to see that you don't have to finish this 4-year degree in computer science.
Right.
What if you become an expert in health? What if you become an expert in mathematics? Can you add coding to that? Can you add development to that? Problem solving to that? All of a sudden, the degree that you develop, no matter which one you take, has added value because you picked up a skill like app development.
That's right.
Yeah, it's not. We're not trying to demonize kind of education because,
no,
like, obviously, like, look who we've got here. Yeah. But it's more like argumenting it. It's more applying it because ultimately we can all go sit in a classroom and not be out in the real world and get experience and get kind of like human connections and see problems and know how to solve them. It's very much kind of it's about because those people that do have the degree, it's about then learning about like doing it the other way, like go into health, go into retail, into to see those problems and stuff and learn how to solve them using what you've learned and stuff. You don't have to be almost chained to your degree.
Totally. In our episode with Charles Lamanna, we had a great conversation about the demand for app developers in not tech. Mm-hmm. So apparently this year, for the first time, for all of you, the demand for people to become developers in retail, finance, marketing, hospitals, government, way the heck higher than demand in tech. Because all these industries are like, hey, we're doing this digital transformation thing, but we need our devs to make our apps, make our websites, make our chatbots, make our lives easier, automate these processes. Where do we get devs from? Do you have any devs to give away? We're like, no, we don't have devs to give away. We can barely, you know, make and keep our own devs because, you know, the number of computer science graduates in the world, that's not going up very high. It's not going up fast enough to fulfill all these jobs. So it's really, really cool to see people like Brian going out into the world and engaging with young people and saying, you, learn to build business apps because you're probably going to be doing this at your job. Mm-hmm. It doesn't even matter what kind of job you have, you're probably going to be doing this at your job. So why not roll up looking like a rock star on day one and say, yeah, I've already built apps for finance, government, medicine, et cetera, et cetera. You're welcome, right? Yeah. Suddenly you're like super technical in like a hospital.
Roll into the interview room.
Yes.
With your app
with your app made.
Oh, wow. Yeah. You would get that job.
Exactly. Yeah. Like, oh, you work for a government agency, do you? Do you ever have a problem with blah? I have an app for that. People are like, who are you even?
Yeah, you're hired. Amazing. Here's your contract.
Exactly, exactly. So wow. Go do that. That's exactly what you should do.
So I've been looking forward to this moment, like, so, like, not that I wanted to, like speed through this. I'm a homework person. I love homework. So, like, part of the show is basically we ask our guests to come with something that you can do, like, now. The big thing is there's no excuses. We've spoken about that, right? That there is no excuses. So, Brian, what have you got? What's the homework that you want for our viewers?
All right. Here it is. Uh-oh. This is the last time you're going to use paper, okay? Take a sheet of paper. Write down every single complaint that you've made in the last 24 hours or last week, right? Write them all down. What are those problems? Then pick one that you care about the most. Solve it by learning how to create your very first app. It's at aka.ms/powerup.
You're right.
So that's the last time you're gonna use paper.
Mm-hmm. That's amazing. That's kind of two, right?
Yes.
We're helping the environment
yes.
and using technology.
Right. Find a problem in your life. Not someone else's life, your own life. You complained about it yesterday. So go write it down, build the app, and share it with us. Tell us what you did.
Yeah, like tag us on Twitter. And also don't, like, if you're kind of like shaking your head saying, I totally didn't make a complaint in the last 24 hours.
Of course you did. You're just a liar. Now you're just a liar, and that's adorable, but you're going to do it anyway. Mm-hmm. And once you build it, tell us what you did, because guess what? We'd love to have you in this chair terrorizing you and hearing about what you did too. All right, we're of course obviously out of time because we don't shut up. So please tune in next week to see who we've got on in the hot seat. Till then, I'm Donna.
I'm Sarah.
And I'm Mr. Dang.
Bye.